قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To another session, our ninth session of learning Quranic Arabic in order to build a deeper connection with the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So alhamdulillah, we are in the ninth session, and again today, unfortunately, we were not able to get my girls on with me here in the studio. So we're going to go solo again. I think we did pretty well last time. So inshallah, we'll try and make the best of it. We surely miss our girls, but what can we do? Technology is not within our hands. Nothing is, really. Okay. All right, so let's continue. In the last session, we did a review. We completed our lesson on the demonstrative pronouns. And if you've been following right from the beginning, what we learned was that there are seven kinds of proper nouns. And that's basically the topic that we are covering at this point, right? So we covered the proper nouns that come with alif lam. We covered the proper nouns that are the names of places, people, locations, etc. And then we did the demonstrative pronouns, which is the pointer, right? هذا هذاني هؤلاء هذه هاتاني هؤلاء. And then you have for far, that was for near, and then for far you have ذلك ذانك أولئك تلك تانك and أولئك. So we covered that, and we learned a couple of properties about the pointers. One of the most important things that we learned is that the pointer, all right, the pointer like هذا or هذه, whatever it is pointing to, it has to match in TGNS unless it is a broken plural of a non-living object, right? So that was the only exception that we covered last week. So again, the TGNS for the pointer and the pointed, they have to match one another. And this concept remains throughout, even in today's lesson. Today's lesson, really, it's just about adding more to your vocabulary. There's nothing really complicated about this topic, all right? These are a few vocab words, you can say, that will be added to your list. And what you will learn is how they are used in the Arabic language. But otherwise, you know, the format of single, dual, plural, you're already familiar with that, right? You're already familiar with the concept of male and female. You're already familiar with the concept of TGNS. So since this is a proper noun, or since this is a noun, right, proper or common does not matter, it will have the type, gender, number, and status. So today's topic again, it's called the relative pronouns. And for our ease of understanding, we can call them, though that's not the only purpose, we can call them connectors, all right? Or even descriptors, beginning as something that leads to a description of something. And let me give you an example. So if you have an example such as the girl slept, okay, the first sentence is the girl slept, the second sentence the girl was tired. If I were to put the two sentences together and make them one, how would I do that? The girl who slept was tired, right? Or give you another example, the boy came yesterday, right? He fell sick. Or the boy fell sick. Two sentences, put it together. The boy who came yesterday fell sick. So the girl who slept was tired. That who is your relative pronoun, is your connector. In Arabic, the who, because it's a girl, the feminine form will be allati. Okay? And then for the boy, because it's masculine, the boy who came yesterday, right? The boy who came yesterday, he fell sick. So the who will be alladhi for the boy, right? So that's, it's as simple as that. How many times in the Quran have you seen alladhi and alladhina, right? Allati, allati. So this is basically what our relative pronouns are. So let's go into the notes. Your notes are uploaded. It's lesson number 9, all right? So it says relative pronoun, relator, all right? You can call it relator, you can call it connector. Let's get into the examples straight, because I gave you the definition. So remember, I told you that it is it is also a fragment, okay? So you have the noun, all right? You have a noun, and followed by the noun, you will have these connectors that sound like alladhi, alladhani, or alladhina, all right? And if it's the feminine, then it's going to be allati, allatani, and allati, all right? So these are the six new words that you're gonna be learning for today, that's all. So the first row, which is the masculine, it's going to be alladhi, alladhani, dual, and then alladhina. And then the feminine form is allati, allatani. I mean, by now, ani should be like common, you should be like second nature for you, right? It's the ending for the dual ending combination. Ani, anytime you see ani, that's your ending dual combination, right? So allatani, and then you have allati, allai. There are some forms, other variations also, and I've put them in your notes. They're there, right, for you to see. I'm gonna go to the chart here. It's on your screen as well. So you see the male, the first line is your male, okay? Let me get my stylus here. Okay, so the first, so this is alladhi, all right? It's your singular. Alladhani will be your plural. Alladhina will be, sorry, alladhani will be your dual. Alladhina will be your plural. Translation, the one who, the ones who, referring to two people, and the ones who, referring to plural. And then you have the female, same meaning, the one who will be allati, allatani, the ones who, both, and then allawati or allati or allai. These are the three forms. Allati is the most common form that you see in the Quran, okay? Allati. So the ones who, those who. So if it's feminine, we're gonna use allati. Make sense? All right, so quickly again, you have your relative pronouns. These are six words, three masculine and three feminine. All right, the three masculine are singular, dual, plural, alladhi, alladhani, alladhina. Feminine, allati, allatani, allati. This should be the easiest lesson so far, right? Okay, so this is your, let's take a look at the examples that are right above the chart. And like I said, your connector, alladhina or alladhi, it has to match, all right? It has to match the noun that it is talking about. So over here, if you look at at-tullabu, okay? At-tullabu is a broken plural. So it's a plural, but tullab means what? Students. So it's living. We're not going to use the feminine singular rule over here, all right? So at-tullabu, right? At-tullabu, what is the connector that we are going to use, or the relator that we are going to use? It's the plural relator that you will use, the masculine form, which is alladhina. All right, you don't have to worry about the second part of the sentence, inshallah, that's not relevant at this time, but just to give you a sense of the sentence, the students, the ones who traveled with us, were righteous. Okay, the students who traveled with us were righteous. Now look at the next one. At-talibani, all right? At-talibani is what? At-talibani is dual. So if it is dual, then the relator that we are going to use also has to be dual. At-talibani is your masculine form. Therefore, our relator also has to be masculine. Alladhani, right? So ani, the two students, right? The two students who, okay? The two students who traveled with us were righteous. Make sense? Simple. Now look at the next one. At-talibu. All right. At-talibu is what? Singular, dual, or plural? It is singular. So when it is singular, what is my relator going to look like? My relator is also going to be singular. All right. So that's alladhi. And the reason we're using alladhi is because talib is masculine. Okay. So the student who traveled with us is righteous. Simple, right? So the way this concept works is, and in the Quran, I mean, it comes everywhere, right? This is, they're all, if you open the Mus'haf, you're gonna see it everywhere. It's gonna stand out even more now. So let me just erase this for you. What is the function of this? The function of this is that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the relative pronouns in the Quran, like alladhina or alladhani or allati or allatani or allai, the masculine or the feminine form, right? If you look at this, this is the noun that is being talked about, okay? Here, this is the noun that is being talked about, all right? And what comes after is the description of this noun. Okay, it's as simple as that. This is the noun, all right? This is the relator, okay? And the portion after is describing this noun. So they're connected that way. All right. Same thing. At-talibu. All right. This is singular. Right. This is the noun that is being talked about, and the details are being provided by this portion. Okay. This is what it's pointing towards. So we have the most common example in the Quran, which is ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Who are the muttaqin? الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ. So you have the description of who. The noun that comes before immediately. There's no gap. All right? They come together. All right? So the noun and the relator, they come together. Now, The noun that comes before الَّذِينَ is what? Muttaqeen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing in the part that comes after الَّذِينَ what the characteristics of the muttaqeen is. Okay? So it's as simple as that. If you have any questions, you can post them. The live chat is on. And if you're not able to join the live classes, students have been reaching out through the comment section also, and that's really good. Post your questions there and give me around 24 to 48 hours. Inshallah, I'll get back to you. All right. But if you have any questions, don't leave yourself confused. All right. There's no reason for you to remain confused. There's always ways that you can clarify. So like I said, either the live chat box or the comment section. All right. So that is the concept that we are introducing today, which is Ismul Mawsula in Arabic. All right. It's called Asma'ul Mawsula. Ism singular, Asma broken plural, nouns. So Asma'ul Mawsula, right? The relative pronouns. Now, because it is a noun, all right, in this, there is one thing that is different from what we didn't see in demonstrative pronouns. For demonstrative pronouns, we just had hadha, and then we said hadha comes with a proper noun. That's it, right? This is basically the structure of a demonstrative fragment, that there is the pointer, and whatever is being pointed in a demonstrative fragment, that has to come attached with alif lam. If it does not come attached with alif lam, then it becomes a complete sentence. We covered that last week. Here, with Asma'ul Mawsula, we have our alladhi, alladhani, and alladhina, allati, allatani, and allati. These are your proper relative pronouns, or proper connectors, or proper relators, whatever you want to call them, right? They're proper. That means what? That means there is a common form also. There's nothing technical about it. You just have to memorize the meaning. That's it. And it is in your next page of your handout, right? If you look at it, there are four, okay? You have man, ma, ayu, and ayatu. Really quickly, what is man used for? Man, whoever, right? So whoever, it is specifically used for the living, all right? Man is specifically used for the living. And then ma is used for the living, all right? Sorry, the non-living and animals, inanimate. Anything that is ghair aqil, all right? That does not have the intelligence. So man is used for anything living, and aqil, meaning some with intelligence, people, it refers to people, all right? But when we use ma, ma is used for objects, and it is used for anything that is ghair aqil, yani does not have the intelligence. Animals will fall under this, all right? And it's the same for both male and female. It's not like there is a feminine form of man or a feminine form of ma. Man is used for both male and female, and then ma is used for both male and female, all right? And then we have ayu, okay? Ayu means whichever, all right? And it is used for both people and inanimate. There's no distinction there. However, it is used for, ayu is the masculine form, all right? Yeah, ayyuhannas, all right? That ayu. How common is it, right? That ayu. So it's used for both male and female. Sorry, it's used for masculine. And then we have ayyatu. Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutmainna, right? Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutmainna. Ayyatu is used for anything that is feminine. Again, ayu used for masculine. Ayyatu used for feminine, all right? Ayyatu hannafsu is a good example for the feminine application of ayyatu. And like we said, there is no distinction in terms of using these for living or non-living. However, with man and ma, we have that distinction, right? Man is for the living. Man fi samawati wal ard, right? Man is for living. And then ma fi samawati wal ard, whatever Allah created, right? Ma fi samawati wal ard. That ma is used for non-living or inanimate. So these are your vocabulary words, if you want to call it, or the words that belong to this concept, which is the relative pronoun, right? You can call them relators or you can call them connectors. Really quickly, before we go into the exercises, the chart, we have the masculine form and then we have the feminine form. The masculine is alladhi, alladhani, alladhina, right? And then the feminine form is allati, allatani, allati, allawati, allai. These are the different forms that you see in the Quran. Allai, allati are the ones that are found in the Quran, okay? So these are your proper relative pronouns, okay? Your proper relative pronouns, meaning they come with nouns that have the alif lam, okay? And then next we have your common relative pronouns or common connectors, which is man, anything living, man is used, right? Anything living, man is used. Anything aqil, yani with intellect, man is used. Anything non-living, object, ghair aqil, without intellect, ma is used. And then we have ayu, which is like ya yuhannas, is the masculine form, right? And then we have ayatu, which is the feminine form of ayu, all right? So these are your relative pronouns, proper and common, okay? Now, continuing, we move to application, all right? So quickly, let's look at these exercises and see if we can figure out which word, right, from the chart here will plug into the blanks over there. It's very simple. Keep in mind, like ism ishara mushar ilay, pointer, pointed. They have to be twins. Same thing over here. The alladhi, okay, or alladhina that comes, it has to match the noun, and the noun will be right before it. So here, let's take a look at it. You have hatani, okay, ism ishara, it's a pointer. Hatani talibatani. Hatani is feminine, at-talibatani is feminine. Hatani is dual, at-talibatani is dual. At-talibatani is rafa, so hatani, even though it does not show the rafa signs, ending combinations or ending sounds, we learned that it will follow, because they're twins, it will follow whatever the noun is showing. Hatani will have the same status, right? And then the type, of course, all these are proper. Hatani, even though it does not have alif lam, it is considered proper, okay? So hatani, at-talibatani, right? What do you think, what pointer is going to come here? Will it be alladhi? Will it be alladhani? Will it be alladhina? Will it be allati? Will it be allatani? Or will it be allati? Al-latani, right? Al-latani, here. Because tani, you have the feminine ending, dual, so all that gives you the hint, and that's what you're gonna put here. So these two students who, all right, these two students who read, are the students who read the Quran today, okay? These two are the students who read the Quran today. Now look at this, the second one. Hadhal waladu. Okay, hadhal waladu, pointer and pointed. This boy, because pointer is hadha, it is followed by a noun that has alif lam. There is no is, am, are. It's a fragment, cannot be a nominal sentence, right? So this boy, now I want to say who over here. What will I put? What will I plug in? Alladhi. Because walad is male, right? It is singular. So alladhi is male, it is singular. Okay? All right. So هَذَا الْوَلَدُ الَّذِي نَائِمٌ فِي الْغُرْفَةِ. This is the boy who is sleeping in the room. Now, if I want to do the TGNS of alladhi, okay? If I want to do the TGNS of alladhi, I simply look at al-walad. Okay? Al-waladu. So my al-waladu's TGNS is what? TGNS. Type is proper, gender is male, number is singular, status is, you see the rafa ending sound? So it's rafa. Same, it will be the same for alladhi. They're twins. It cannot be different. Okay? The broken plural rule that we learned with ism ishara, mushar ilay in the last class, the pointer and the pointed, will apply here also. Meaning, if there's a broken plural that is non-living, we'll use the feminine singulars. Like I told you last time, this concept, it will remain throughout. Even when we study the verbs, this concept will carry over even there. That whenever we have a broken plural that is non-living, it is going to be treated feminine singular. Okay? All right. So next, number three, هَؤُلَاءِ الطَّالِبَاتُ. Right? هَؤُلَاءِ الطَّالِبَاتُ. هَؤُلَاءِ is a mishara or pointer, and we see the pointed الطَّالِبَاتُ. All right. What do you think will come here? We're gonna plug in because atu, we see the feminine ending combination, right? So it's we have to look at the feminine chart. That's the first thing. Second, we see atu. What is the number? The number is singular or dual or plural. Atu is our plural ending combination, right? So therefore, we're gonna put allati over here, okay? Allati. Here you go, okay? All right, so these girls, haula ittalibatu, these girls are the ones who are sleeping in the room. These girls are the ones. So the one, the which, we polish it according to how it makes sense in English, all right? So these girls are the ones who are sleeping in the room. Next, number four, we have هَؤُلَاءِ الْأَوْلَادُ. All right, هَؤُلَاءِ الْأَوْلَادُ, pointer and the pointed, they match each other in all the four. So we're reviewing concepts also here, right? They match each other in all the four. And of course, the one that is going to come here, the relator that is going to come here, it has to match the noun, this noun, okay? And what is this noun? الْأَوْلَادُ. It's a broken plural, أَوْلَاد, right? Broken plural for walad, and the broken plural for walad, what is the meaning? Children. Children, it's living. Because it is living, what is it that we're going to use over here? Even though it's broken plural, remember, broken plural, feminine. If it is broken plural and non-living, we use feminine singular, right? But if it is broken plural and living, we're going to use whatever the gender, according to its gender. All right, so al-awladu al-ladina. Here. These children are the ones who are sleeping in the ghurfa, okay? Are sleeping in the room. So let me erase this really quick so it is clear. And here you go. Okay, so here, what did we do? So what is the function of our alladhina, alladhina, the relators? What's the function? What if we have alladhina over here, right? Alladhina. If we have alladhina over here, this noun, all right? Alladhina is the connector to the second part of the sentence, okay? It's a connector to the second part of the sentence. And the second part of the sentence is what? It's not talking about anything different. It's talking about this noun. All right, this is what you need to keep in mind. It is giving us the description, like we said, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. So, يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ, all that is talking about what? It's talking about the muttaqin. Okay, so that's the function basically of all these relative pronouns that we learned here. Hope that is clear. The next exercise is very simple. Before we get into the Quranic drill, 9b, you just use the appropriate relative pronoun to plug in there. All right, I'll do it really quickly. Al-kitabu, you have alladhi, all right, because it's singular, so you're gonna, and it's masculine, you're gonna use alladhi. Al-muslimuna, because it's plural, you're gonna use alladhina, all right, and then al-muslimatu, because it is plural, because it is feminine, you're gonna use allati. Okay, and then ash-shamsu. Ash-shamsu is feminine, right? And of course, it's singular, so we're gonna use allati. All right, al-qamaru is masculine, and of course, it's singular, so we're gonna use alladhi. Okay, al-ma, water, is treated as singular, and it's male. Again, it's gonna be alladhi. All right, al-madrasatani, two schools, dual, and it is feminine, so allatani. Okay. Al-latani, al-kawakibu. Al-kawakibu is a broken plural, okay? It means planets, all right? It's a broken plural, and it is planets, non-living, right? Non-living, broken plurals, treated as feminine singular. What's our feminine singular? Al-lati, Okay? All right. And then we have an-nujum, broken plural. Remember the format from the last class? Sudur, qulub, fu'ul. It's a broken plural format. Nujum means what? Stars. So it is broken plural. It is stars. The meaning is telling me that it is non-living. If it is non-living and if it is broken plural, we use what? Feminine singular. All right? So an-nujum again will be allati. There you go. It's done. Okay? So that is our lesson for today. I want to apply these concepts, and I know last class we were not able to do the ayahs that I had put down for practice. So either you open your lesson 8 handout, okay? If you don't have the lesson 8 handout in front of you, that's fine. You can just open the mushaf and you can follow along with me. All right, so you can have the lesson 8, the handout that is there in the link below, or you can open your mushaf, and in your mushaf, please take out Surah Qadr. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. Quickly, we're going to do a quick analysis of the ayahs of that surah and also build some vocabulary, very appropriate during this time, right? And apply the concepts that we have learned so far, inshallah. Okay, so let's look at Surah Qadr here. If it should be visible on your screen, all right? Surah Qadr here. Look at this one. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. You are only limited to the knowledge of nouns. So you are going to identify the nouns in this ayah, the nouns that you have learned, right? You've not covered all kinds of nouns yet. So the noun that you have learned, you can identify al-qadri. Right? Because it has what? It has alif lam. So really quickly, if I were to do a TGNS of al-qadri, what will it be? It will be type is proper, right? Type is proper, and then gender is al-qadri, gender is male, right? There are no feminine indicators there. Number, singular, right? Status is what? You see the kasra over here? Okay? What is it? Jar. Okay, so this is your noun. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadri. Indeed, we sent it down on the night of Qadr. Okay, this word that you see over here, anzalna, you know, sometimes in the Quran you see anzalna and then you see nazzalna al kitab also, and both of it are referring to the book. What is the difference? I want to highlight the difference here. Probably it will motivate you to understand Arabic and also understand the barriers that come into place because of translation, right? The translation can only allow us, or it gives us a superficial sense of the meaning of the words, but it cannot take us in depth. When Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala uses anzalna in the Quran, and then he uses nazalna also in other places. Both are verbs, all right? You've not learned verbs, but this is just a point I want to make. Anzalna, Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala uses when he is talking about Quran coming down from Lawhul Mahfuz, right, to Bayt al-Izzah at once, which happened at the night of Laylatul Qadr, which is what we are seeking in these last 10 nights, right? That night from Lawhul Mahfuz to Bayt al-Izzah, the doors of revelation were open after a gap of 600 years for the last time, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to reveal his final word to humanity, and that is the phenomena, that is the process, that is the occurrence that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about in this ayah or in this surah, right? Anzalna. But when he uses nazalna is when from Bayt al-Izzah, which is the lowest level of the skies, right? From Bayt al-Izzah, when Jibreel alayhi salam brought down revelation to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam over a span of 23 years. All right, that is what tanzil refers to, or nazzalna refers to. That's the subtlety in the usage of the words, which translation will never capture. Okay, so inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr. Qadr is the noun. Moving on over here, wama adraka ma laylatul qadr. Again, the noun that you have learned is al qadr over here. You may think like we just learned ma with the relative pronouns. One thing you have to learn is that there are different ma's in the Arabic. Not to confuse you too much, but it just has different meanings. And according to context, you will understand what the meaning of the ma is, right? Over here, this is not the ma that we just covered in relator. So we're going to pass on and we just look at al-qadri. That is the noun you identify. The translation is what will tell you how amazing that night of power is. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next ayah, he talks about or he tells us what that Laylatul Qadr is. The construction, maybe you can take this, you can mark this on in your mushaf, because these are points that, you know, you just get introduced to them. There is nothing technical about it, but these are facts and you can have them anytime you come across them. You can always apply. Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses wama adraka in the Quran, right, versus wama yudrika. So al-qari'atu mal-qari'ah, wama adraka mal-qari'ah, al-haqqatu mal-haqqah, wama adraka mal-haqqah. When he uses wama adraka, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the following ayah, he provides an answer to it. Like over here, okay, wama adraka ma laylatul qadr, he's explaining what that laylatul qadr is, right? But when he uses wama yudrika la'allahu yazzakka, like you have in Abasa, there's no answer after that. That's the difference between wama adraka and wama yudrika. All right. So wama adraka ma laylatul qadr khayrun min alf shahr. So you have qadri again, which is your noun, and then you have khayrun, that is your noun, right? And then shahrin, that is the noun that you have recognized or that you have learned. Khayrun means better. Okay, shahrun is months, alf, thousand. Okay, more, better than, more, or it's more superior, more better than the worship that is for, that is done for 1,000 years, right? 1,000 months, and 1,000 months, it's equivalent to what? It's equivalent to 83 years and 4 months. That is more than the average lifespan of the Muslim Ummah. The average lifespan of the Muslim Ummah is what? It's 63, 62, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every year of our lives, this is the opportunity that he gives us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to maximize the most of these remaining nights that are quickly passing us by. Ameen. Now you have tanazzalul malaika. What happens? He's still describing, right? Tanazzalul malaika war ruh. So malaika is your noun, okay? You can do the TGNS here, right? Malaika, type proper, gender feminine. What is telling me it's feminine? You have the ta marbuta there, okay? And then you have number, malaika, all right? It is plural. And then you have status, which is rafa, okay? Malaika, and then ruh. What is the ruh referring to? Common knowledge, Jibreel alayhi salam, right? So malaika and angels. So angels and malaika, they come down in it, in the night of Qadr, bi'idhni rabbihim, by the will of their Rabb, min kulli amrin. Amrin is also your noun, okay? And you can do the TGNS really quick. Type is common, gender is masculine, number is singular, and status is jar. And then the last ayah, salamun hiya hatta matla' al-fajr, the nouns that you can identify is salam over here, salamun, and then fajr is the break of dawn, is the salatul fajr, of course, and you can easily do the TGNS. So inshallah, with this, we will conclude our today's lesson. You can review the concepts that you have learned by taking any small passage of the Quran. You can take the ayahs that are there that you commonly recite. That way, what happens is you build vocabulary also. So, and you know, just learning the concepts is not enough. You have to build vocabulary, and vocabulary is something that you have to do on your own. A teacher cannot help you build vocabulary. That effort has to come from you. And the most that we can do, or the most that the way we can facilitate learning of your vocabulary is use as many Quranic exercises as possible for practice, and then you make your notes on the mushaf. All right, so that way whenever you turn the pages of your mushaf, it's right there and your memory gets refreshed. All right, so inshallah, with this I will conclude. We will not have class, of course, next week. It's Eid break, and inshallah I will see you after the Eid break. Keep us in your du'as, keep everyone in your du'as, especially the Epic management team, that, you know, they have provided us with all these wonderful services throughout the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for each one of us, and may he give us the beautiful destiny that each one of us are praying for, yearning for, longing for, desiring for. May he give us the fortune, may he give us the qadr, may he give us the destiny of coming out of this month free, cleansed of all our sins. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, salamun ala al-mursaleen, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.